Hooray! Last man standing on European Parliament election night.
It's quite tricky to summarise what's really 28 national elections rolled into one big one, but let's give it a go. First of all, the rise of anti-EU forces, which everyone was predicting before this election, turned out to be much more complicated than that. In some countries, they did not do very well. In others, they did really well.
Non solo la Lega è il primo partito in Italia, Marine Le Pen è il primo partito in Europa, in Francia Nigel Farage è il primo partito in Gran Bretagna.
That's not great news for President Emmanuel Macron of France because he got beaten by Marine Le Pen's national rally, something he really wanted to avoid. The other story of the night, what they're calling the Green Wave. Really strong performances by the Greens, particularly in Germany.
Das sind Stimmen für den Klimaschutz. Das sind Stimmen für die Demokratie.
So, what does it mean for this place? Well, for decades, it's basically been controlled by parties from the centre-right and the centre-left working together. They did not win enough seats for that to carry on, so they will have to work with the Liberals or with the Greens. In terms of the UK, well, they're sending lots and lots of Brexit Party MEPs and quite a few Liberal Democrat MEPs. They will stay until Brexit finally happens. And there's one thing that pretty much everyone seems happy about. The number of people who voted in this election has gone up compared to last time. The first time that's ever happened.